Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about the visually challenged persons, how they learn, how they study, how they used to read, all these things we are going to study in this lesson. Now, if you will see how you all have seen how the visually challenged persons are. Okay, they don't have the ability to see the world. Okay, so they comes under the visually challenged persons. Okay, but some persons they are visible, means they can see, but how they can see? They can see in a very small amount, okay, because of some disease. So they also comes under visually challenged persons. For such conditions, means at the time of birth only some people are not able to see at all, okay, but some persons are there who can see, but they can see very faint. So for such person, for such people, what happens? Some aids are developed or produced to enhance their reading or learning and for their study purpose. So for such people, if you will see, some resources are there which makes them or which makes them able to read or learn. Okay, so what are the resources? They are classified into two types. The resources, non-optical aids and optical aids. These two are firstly classified into two types. So what are non-optical aids? Non-optical aids are the instruments which helps them to learn or which helps them to read or which helps them to listen. All these things comes under this non-optical aids. For example, visual aid. Visual aid means what? With which they can visualize. Means now some people are not able to see some larger distant things. For such persons, what happens? Some magnifiers are there which helps to magnify. Okay, so such a visual aids comes under this. So tactile means what? Tactile aids means which helps the person to read or listen with the help of touching. Okay, with the help of touching, what happens? They sense that and they used to learn or used to study. For such persons, what happens? Some slates are prepared, with the help of stylus they can use to read it. Then next it comes to the auditory aids. Auditory aids means they help to listen, means for hearing purpose. The hearing purpose, such aids are there. In that, many are there. Some audio books are there, cassettes are there, CD players are there, which helps them to listen that. Okay, while with the help of listening, they can understand actually what it is. So such devices are there which helps them to hear or listen, or which helps them to for the study purpose. Then next come the electronic aid. In electronic aid, there are many electronic devices. For example, there are closed circuit televisions are there. Then many instruments are there, many screens are there which helps them to study. Okay, all these things are there which helps them for their enhancement. Now, if you will see in optical aids means what? It is related to the lenses which helps them to, some lens helps them to reduce the defects, some helps them to magnify and see the object. So such optical aids are for a bifocal lenses are there. Then contact lenses are there. Then tinted lens, magnifiers and the telescopic aids. All these are the lenses which helps if the person's vision can be restored by using such lenses, then these sources are used for such people. Maybe they can be used combinedly also. If some person need two or three lens, combination of lenses are also taken for to improve the visual. Now we are going to study a very important, now recently used by the people, which are benefit, the peoples are benefit by using this, is the Braille system. This is a very important system for the visually challenged persons, which makes the people to read and write because of the Braille system. So Louis Braille, who also was a visually challenged person, and what happened? This system was introduced first by the Louis Braille. So actually, what is this? What is Braille system? It is a system, means it is a combination of dots or patterns which helps the visually challenged person to read properly. Okay, actually, and because of this Braille, means in Braille system there are Braille codes which helps to the visually challenged person. These codes are for some common languages, for maths, and from some scientific notations are also there, which helps the people to read properly. Now, in this, actually, what is Braille? It is a 63 dot patterns. Okay, dotted patterns are there. So, as you all have studied ABCD, from that only you started making the words, then sentences. Okay, similarly, this visually challenged person also, first they have to study the dot patterns, they also have to study the ABCD, but in the dot pattern. Okay, when they study these basic things, after that what happens, they combine it and they start making a word, and after word then to the sentence. This way they use this dot pattern and they learn the words or they read. Okay, now here a small example is given. You can see here, for if the person want to read this, what happens, how they will read. Actually, before going to this, I want to tell you that this dot pattern, as they don't see anything, they use their fingers, with the help of their fingers they touch the letter so that they are able to read. This means they are able to identify the words. Actually, this Braille, this dot patterns are embossed in the Braille sheet. Okay, and the Braille sheet, when these people touch the Braille sheet, they can feel the dots fit to their fingers, and because of that sensation, what happens, they are able to identify the letters. Now if you will see here, for C, now there are two dots at the top line. Actually, how it is arranged? It is arranged, two vertical rows are arranged with the three dots. Okay, three dots it is arranged. Now if you will see here, see the four letters C. If you will see, two dots are at the top and other all are dash. Means this indicate that this letter is C. If you will see A, A means only one dot. First dot, other all blank. Means that letter indicates it is A. If they touch it, if they feel only one dot at the first top, then they feel that it is a A. And for T, same. If they touch and if they sense this pattern, okay, this pattern, if they sense, then they can identify that is T. Okay, so they combine this letter C A T and they can read that it is a cat. Okay, this way they are able to study the Braille system. Okay, this is very useful for such persons. And as you all know, if in the visually challenged persons, even though they are not able to see, okay, clearly, but they have the ability or they have developed other senses very highly, such that they can easily grasp such things. Okay, they can easily feel such things. They have developed their other senses very strongly, and because of that, it is they can do this properly, or they can read this properly. Writers like devices, then printing machine, printing devices are also developed for such people. This was our last topic from the lesson. We have completed the lesson. So after the completion of this video, you just read the textbook and start solving the exercise. Thank you.